Well, you know, we are talking about indices at all-time highs. So where are the pockets of undervaluation, Nilesh?
At this index, I don't think so we will be able to find much pockets of undervaluation. What we'll have to find out is what market is pricing in terms of growth versus what is potentially achievable in terms of growth. There will be pockets where market has priced in too much growth, like some of the consumption stocks or retailing stocks. And there will be pockets where market is probably priced in little less growth than what is achievable. Mm. This will be mainly in quality mid-caps where franchisee business is solid, governance is intact, and the business volumes are coming through as the economy has started recovering. There's one more point which, Lata, I want to raise, and that is the potential disruption which can come into market from events which we can't even imagine today. We have a lot of foreign investors' interest in India. In many companies, they own majority ownership. Their voting is decided by global proxy voting agencies. They, based on their judgment, opine whether they should vote in favor of a resolution or vote against the resolution. Mm. And most of these FIIs tend to kind of blindly follow proxy voting agencies' resolution. If they want to go against it, then they have to go through an elaborate process to justify why they are taking a different call. Mm-hmm. Clearly, in many of our companies, we have surrendered our sovereignty to proxy voting agencies. Mm. And today's headline does suggest what could have happened if investors had blindly followed global proxy voting agencies. Mm. Now, this could cause a major disruption in the established management or some of the bluest of blue chip companies. Yep. I think this is one disruption which we need to factor in. Mm. And all the corporates will have to engage with this proxy voting agency in a much more diligent manner. Mm. Clearly, there is cultural difference between developed market and emerging market, between family-owned companies and professionally-owned companies. And someone sitting in a, you know, remote corner of the world, away from Indian culture, Indian values, Indian business ethics, cannot opine, you know, which can create such a major disruption. So we need to engage with proxy voting agencies far more, and that is one cause of disruptions which we need to be aware of.
Okay, that's extremely well put. 22.6% negative vote for Deepak Parekh. That was not lost on anyone.